I have a light grip on this with my finger. Nothing crazy firm, no death grip. Hi, I'm Brian Hare from Free Salon Education. I want to take you back to start us off to the year 2013. We had Macklemore teaching us about the thrift shop. We had Robin Thicke teaching us about blurred lines. We had Katy Perry teaching us how to roar. We also had a girl by the name of Tori Locklear teaching us what not to do when it comes to waving our hair with a YouTube tutorial mishap.
And then like, do it like this.
That happened. Poor thing. It seems everybody saw that video. Not everybody learned the lessons from that video, because here we are 8 years later and we still have people that don't quite understand how to prevent that from happening. So that's what I wanted to do with this video. I wanted to go over the what, why, and how to sort of address that issue and keep that from being somebody else's problem in the future. The what of the situation is that she burned her damn hair off. Seems pretty simple. The why is where I get to come in and help you out a little bit. There's a couple of different things that could cause that to happen. Not necessarily saying that this is exactly what happened to her, but they are some whys on how this could happen to you and what you can do to prevent that. The first and foremost is if your iron is too hot. Her iron may have been way too hot. It could have been one of those irons where you don't have control over the heat, because way too hot of an iron is gonna burn right through that hair. You would never use a Star Wars lightsaber to curl your hair, because you know it's gonna cut right through your hair. There's not that much of a difference if you've got an iron with no heat control or with it turned way, way, way too high. Another possibility is if the hair was wet. The spray that she was using, you can tell by the nozzle, it has a wet delivery. When you have wet hair, it has a higher elasticity. And so what that means is your hair, based on its texture and condition or moisture level, can be more stretchy. And the more it stretches, the less structural integrity it has. So by putting pressure onto that structural integrity, you could also cause breakage or the hair to just tear. If you wrap the hair way too tight around an iron or press down too hard, you're also causing too much strain on the structural integrity of the hair and therefore cause it to rip, break, burn, tear, all those bad things that you never want to associate with hair. So rather than just tell you what not to do, I wanted to address those issues and help you with what to do in that kind of situation. First and foremost, addressing the too hot of an iron. You should be working with an iron. In this day and age, it is not hard to find something that gives you temperature control. If you are somebody who's going to heat style your hair ever, you need to be in control of how much heat you're putting on that hair, because nothing trashes hair faster than tools that are too hot. If you're someone that's going to style your hair often, you especially need to be taking care of this, because it's just gonna age your hair really fast and lead to more mishaps like this if you're not in control of the heat. If an iron goes up to 400, just remember that 400 is what you would cook an entire Thanksgiving dinner on. So maybe dial that back a little bit. Talk to your hairdresser, talk to a friend, talk to somebody else about what temperature you think you should be using on your hair. As far as thermal protectants go, that's the biggest one that I have that conversation with my guests a lot, because there are several different types. I brought a couple here to show you. We use Paul Mitchell in my salon, so I just have different Paul Mitchell ones right now. And I wanted to just explain the difference between wet thermal protection and dry thermal protection. You've got Heat Seal, you've got the NeuroStyle Prime. A good indicator about what to use is the actual delivery system itself. When I pump this, it's a much wetter liquid that comes out. Therefore, that should tell you that it should be going in wet hair. If you have a wet thermal protection, it should be on wet hair used for blow drying. That goes for creams as well. This is more of a lotion or a cream that also would wet hair if you put it on to dry hair, which should tell you it's for blow drying, not iron work. If you're looking for something for iron work, be it curling iron, flat iron, whatever your jam is, you're gonna wanna look for something that has a much drier delivery system. And then I wanted to address like the tension issue by just showing you a little technique. I went ahead, I got this girl most of the way going so that you don't have to watch me do an entire head, but I did leave this side out for you. So we're gonna put together all of the different things. I'm gonna go in with a decent temperature. I have my Neuro wand right here. I'm gonna let it go to 350 because the texture of this hair has been lightened, so it's not going to need something too hot, but it is a little bit more coarse of an actual texture itself, so it can handle a little bit higher of a temperature. And then you're gonna make sure that you're giving it some thermal protection. And then I noticed in hers, she had a death grip that she wrapped real hard around, and that's a little too much. For me as a stylist, it's easier to come in this way. If you're doing this on yourself, you may want to come up from under, but I am wrapping away from the face. I have a light grip on this with my finger, nothing crazy firm, no death grip, because I don't want to add too much tension. I don't want to stress the hair out because this is a hot iron. And if I'm applying too much pressure, too much heat, it's just too much stress for the hair. As far as getting a little bit more structured of a curl, rather than the softer wave, you can still use your wand, but now I'm just gonna make sure that I'm feeding the hair onto the wand in a flatter technique rather than holding it like a rope and wrapping it around. You let go, you see it's a little more corkscrew. Still give it that little tug for softness. All right, so once you've let everything cool, I like to come through, give it a nice little brush through, and that will help to take out the structure of the curl that you put in, again, resulting in a nice soft wave. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up on the Instagrams at hairstyle. Be sure to go to freesaloneducation.com, download our app for whatever kind of device you're using, and come play with us. Watch all our videos, check out all the tutorials, and become part of our community.